Hello, dear ones. Been a while. The old body has been deranged a bit. Still is a bit, but here we are, together again for the first time, as somebody said. The main purpose for this little video is just to say thank you. I owe a huge debt of gratitude to several wonderful people who have seen these videos and looked at the website and read the books, who have contributed financially to the well-being of this old fart. And it's deeply, deeply appreciated, much needed, I gotta tell you. And, you know, first off, I just want to thank you for being. For being generous, yes, but just for being. And even though there's no one here and there's no one out there, and the experiences of one talking to itself, there is still this wondrous dream of identities and manifestation that is amazing. The amazing journey. And the dream goes on, and in the dream, it all seems so very real, doesn't it? So when the sages tell us it's a dream, it's like, well, it doesn't feel like a dream to me. It doesn't look like a dream to me. It looks like I'm separate from everything else and other people and so on and so on and so forth. But as Bob Adamson famously says, what's wrong with right now unless you think about it? Where is time right now unless you think about it? Where is any separation right now unless you think about it? Or if you look at another object across the room, please pick something out, and certainly that object, let's say it's a table. The table appears to be separate from you, right? But only if you consider it to be so. If you don't consider that the table is separate, there is no separation, because separation is only a concept. So the me, which is a concept, has taken on board the concept of separation, and therein lies the root of suffering, the notion of a me that is separate from totality. So, again, thank you for your generous spirit, your generous donations. Your contributions have made a big difference here in the dream of this old fart. And it's, again, deeply appreciated. Now, I got a few more things I want to say. The dream goes on and it seems real, and I said that. And it seems like we have to row our boats, you know, row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Hey, seems like we have to do it, doesn't it? But there's evidence now that any thought which precedes any action arises a few nanoseconds before the brain receives it from consciousness. So there is something that is programming the organism to move in very much the same way that a computer is programmed to act in certain ways. This little camera has got a computer chip in it that has it act and react in certain ways. Without the programming of that chip, it would just be a dead piece of hardware. Without the programming of the organism would be dead meat. And, you know, let's be clear about that. There's no such thing as an enlightened organism. There is enlightenment here, present, in the now, here, where you are, here, where, quote, I am, here. But let's be clear. I am, but there is no me. You are, but there is no me. Not in you, nor in anyone else. And enlightenment is very simply, as Ramesh Balsekar beautifully put it, the deepest possible understanding that you are not the doer, nor is anyone else. And that actions happen, as the Buddha said, actions happen, deeds are done, but there is no individual doer that can be found anywhere. If you go in for surgery and you ask the surgeon to locate the doer, or the author, or the writer, or the architect of your life, all he's going to find is a bunch of meat, right? Organs, cells. All there is consciousness, and that consciousness has appeared or is appearing as this manifestation and has kind of conned itself into considering itself to be each of these separate entities. But the same self looks through all these 7 billion pairs of eyes. The same awareness is aware as I am. The same I am, the one I am, is all there is in the manifestation. And even before that, before the I Am appears, you are as this pure awareness, not conscious of itself. Awareness becomes consciousness and becomes conscious. When awareness becomes conscious, intelligence becomes intelligent, and the manifestation becomes manifesting. That is to say, all there is the livingness of the manifesting. Life is a verb. All there is what's happening. There's no such thing as a static life. Life is lifing, and having a good time doing it, no matter what it feels like to the organism, who may be programmed to love some stuff and hate other stuff, but that's part of the dance, that's part of the play. As a friend of mine said, you know, whatever the music is, my job is to dance. And I kind of like that. So, we say hallelujah, we say Hare Krishna, we say God, we say, who cares what we say? You know, the celebration of life is what's happening right now. This is the celebration of life living itself. And we are being lived by consciousness, by the awareness arising as consciousness, arising as the particles of this manifest organism. It's all an appearance, like a dream, and at the same time, part of the dream is that it's got to seem really real. You ever get a dream in the middle of the night where, you know, you're dreaming and you dream, I've had this dream where you drive off a cliff and you're headed down for the rocks. I've had that dream. You know, obviously, the organism woke up before the dream, you know, was crash burn. So I often wonder what it would be like to have the complete crash burn and then wake up. But I kind of found that out in 1977 when everything went away and there was nothing. And not nothing that's a really great big empty something, but really nothing. And then there was everything, and then there was love. So, where's God? Where is Allah? Where is Krishna? Where is God? Let's talk about God for a moment. Where is God? Can you find her, him, it? Where is God? You know, maybe God is, to paraphrase a pop song a few years ago, maybe God is all of us. And maybe we have separated ourselves from God only in thinking where's any separation from God unless you think about it. And do you think you're other than God? You think you're separate from me? Well, what are you then? You know, where, find it. Go to your surgeon and ask him to open up your body and find you, the entity that you consider yourself to be. Can you? No. He's not going to find it. You're not going to find it. So it kind of comes down to, okay, I am. I know I am. I am. Anything that follows I am, you're not that. 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 I am is as close as you can get with words to the timeless reality that you are, that everything is. The I Am appears and the world appears all at once together. Pardon me, you and the world, you as I Am and the world manifest universe appear, arise together. No you, no world, you know. If we take you out, the manifestation will keep on moving along, but there won't be any separate organism to be conscious of itself as something as either part of the whole or separate from the whole. So what? So, just this. Die before you die. And then do what you like. It's all good. Stole that from a Zen master named Bunky. Another one I like a lot, and you can really ponder this one if you like, and we'll see where it takes whatever's going on there. See what happens, is nothing is as it appears. And it is not otherwise. Nothing is as it seems, nor is it otherwise. A bit paradoxical, of course. So, you know, you can kind of dwell on the paradox. And dwell in the I Am. The I Am is certain. You cannot be talked out of being, can you? You know, if I ask you to not be for the next 10 seconds, don't be. Just don't be right now. Now, how's it going? Did you stop being? No. You are being. That is absolutely incontrovertible. You cannot escape it. It's absolutely obvious that you are, isn't it? And that isness of the you are is what we're calling the I am or you are. That is incontrovertible, and no one can argue out of the knowingness that here I am being here now. You are here, it is now. And you are here, and it is now. And you are here, and it is now. It's always fresh, always new, and never conceptual. This pure presence of awareness that you are has no concept to it. Presence awareness is just words that point to it. And it's not really an it, so, you know, the moment we try to use language to describe the indescribable, well, you can kind of figure out where that's going to go. Anyway, I just wanted to get back in touch via these YouTube videos with, again, a great big thank you. Your generosity has enabled the organism to, you know, have food and shelter, and it's much appreciated. Medical care is happening, and food is happening, and shelter is happening, and this old fart will be 75 in December, and hey, you know, this is what it looks like. This is it. So, to sum up, this is it. All there is all there is. And you are not a thing. Not even a really great big huge thing. You can say, I am God, I am Shiva, I am Allah. God is great, Shiva is great, Allah is great. You can say these things, but all they are is words. Where do they point? Where is it that they're pointing to? That's the question. And I'll sum up the teaching in just a few words that I learned from a very, very dear friend named Dorothy Rosenberg. This is all there is. And that's not what she said. That was something somebody else said. But it's as good a pointer as any. Okay. What Dorothy said is, what is, what ain't, and that's that. And there's only that. Not this, not this, not this, not this, not this, just that, which arises as I am and manifestation all at once, and they're not two. Hey, I hope you enjoyed this. I did. Pardon me. Now, let's see. What's next? I don't know. I don't even know what my next thought's going to be to you. What's wrong with right now, unless you think about it? I'll finish with a poem by E.E. Cummings. Seeker of truth, follow no path. All paths lead where? The truth is here. Have a great now. That's all we got. Thanks for watching. And feel free to get in touch if you like. The phone number and address and all of that is at the end of the video. Cheers. I love you. I am, but there is no me. You are, but there is no you.